Hi everyone, Arturo Spraycasso here. Welcome back to another Spraycasso show. I want to thank you guys, first of all, for all the wonderful emails, questions, and comments that you guys have sent us. But I do have one big announcement. Unfortunately, I will not be able to continue the show for a few weeks, but I know, but I do have a replacement, wonderful spray paint master. If you please, I'll let him explain. Hi everyone, my name is Bob Casso. Yeah, before we get started, can I get one of those cool little suits with the can and the zipper and... Alright. Anyways, everyone, I'm gonna be the replacement for Spraycasso. So, between me and you, I'm probably better than he is. So if you guys get your spray paints and your straight edges and all that cool stuff, you know, let's go paint some happy little trees. Come on. Okay, so the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna create a border. Now I'm gonna make this border just black. I'm not gonna add any detail to it. You can add detail to your borders, right? You add some light colors underneath, place the dark color, in this case black, on top, add some texture with the magazine sheet, and you got instant texture. Now you can do that, except in this case I believe I'm gonna leave it black. And this is a nice refresher for those of you who haven't made borders in a while. Okay, so we add our black, we wait for this to dry. Make sure it's dry to the touch. Don't just wait 5 minutes and say, okay, it should be dry. No, make sure you feel it first, and then place your painter's tape on top of that. Now you're gonna want to do this to all four corners, right? And it doesn't matter what size of tape you have, you can get a thicker one. I think this one is 3/4 of an inch. You can get an inch. Now next, I'm gonna grab my Spraycasso tool. This is where I keep it, and this is where I keep some of my tips for my Spraycasso funnel as well. Helps me make different line widths, different shapes. Pretty nifty. I'll show you guys that later. Now, for this painting, I'm not going to use the Spraycasso tool as much as you guys probably think I would use it, right? But it'll come in pretty handy. Now, this is a stencil I made. You can make this painting without creating a stencil. I made a stencil in case I want to reproduce this painting later on, maybe make a similar one. And, you know, I encourage you guys to try this technique, as it may help you speed things up a little bit, especially if you're going to do this in... while performing live. You don't want to sit there and create the tiger yourself, because it may take a while. So you may use a stencil to help you, and I'm going to show you that technique. But first, okay, I went ahead and I added the black lines. Now, as you guys may know, I don't use a wide range of colors. I usually stick to the basic ones. So I'm going to use a little bit of orange, and I'm gonna tone it down just a little bit, because we don't want the nose to be completely orange, right? So we're gonna do a mixture of orange and red. So we're gonna add a light layer of red on top of this. And you see how the Spraycasso tool is coming very handy to help me maintain the stencil down flat. Good. All right. So far we have the nose. Right, that was a little bit of orange with a light layer of red on top of that. Okay, now this is what you have. Now this would be good for maybe an intermediate level painting, but this is going to be a master painting, so we're going to go over it, do a few little changes to it. I'm going to choose point number 102 for this next detail, and as you can tell, there's different shapes, and that's the one I need right there. Very fine point. And I'm just gonna place this right here. Close it up, nice and tight. All right, Now, this is going to help me create the effect of a very realistic looking eye. Now, the eye is not going to be the only realistic looking thing in this painting. I'll show you guys. I went ahead and I put some green inside this spraycasso funnel. And here I'm just practicing off in the side. Make sure it comes out just perfect. And it won't take long. I just want to drop. Now the beauty about this thing is that it'll give you a pretty round drop. You see that? Okay, I'm going to add a little bit of white. And this is going to be for texture inside the eye. Now this is one of the master techniques that I use when creating paintings for either a gallery or, you know, just more advanced. I'm just going to add a drop inside of this. See that? Now the paintings don't completely mix. I'm going to use a spraycasso tool here to kind of mix them together a little bit. Now, by going back and forth, I'm creating a texture within the eye. Do you guys see that? It's going to take a little bit of practice, guys, and maybe perhaps you guys don't want to spend this much time if you're doing this live, but I thought it was time I'd show you guys a little master technique, and it'll make this painting a lot more realistic. And later on I'm gonna get into the techniques that I use for creating, you know, human faces, etc. But first things first, right? So I'm just gonna mix the two colors. I'm gonna get this texture within the iris of the eye. And if you guys are like me, pretty much a perfectionist, you're going to do this several times until you get the desired effect that you're looking for. Alright. Now, what I'm going to do is, I went ahead and I added a little bit, a drop of white, two drops of white, and one black in the middle. Do you see that? And that'll give the effect that the eye is not only moist, but that there's light reflecting off of it. Now I'm using tape here because I'm gonna create, I'm gonna shadow it. I'm gonna add a little bit of shadow to this eye. And I'm just gonna use a flexible straight edge, in this case just a magazine sheet. I'm gonna spray directly onto the sheet and bounce the shadow onto the eye. So you don't wanna spray it directly onto the eye. Right? And that creates a little shadow. Now that's gonna come in very handy as we continue with our tiger. Now I use liquid latex to cover the eye. Now you guys have seen me use this technique on the church tutorial, right, and a few others. So we're just gonna wait for that to dry. While we do that, I'm gonna grab the sea sponge. I'm just gonna create the fur. Now this is the grass technique, guys. This is the same technique that I use to create grass. So you guys will hear me call it either the grass technique or the fur technique. There's a slight difference between the two. It becomes the grass technique once you start adding some highlights to it. Right. So we're just making quick strokes upwards. Now keep in mind that when you do this, you're also going to have maybe even follow a pattern of fur, you know, because if you take a close look at your dogs, maybe a cat, you'll see that they have a pattern, you know, the hair flows in a certain angle. So you guys just don't want to do it randomly either, because then your tiger may look very shaggy. Maybe like he got out of a fight or something. So anyways, try and stick to a pattern, you know, the direction of flow. You know, it helps also if you get a picture of a tiger. Okay. In this case, well, you know, I've had cats in the past, so I'm kind of going by memory here. But I think it'll be okay as long as we stick to a pattern. You see how the fur on the nose goes straight up? And then around the eye, well, it curves a little bit. Now, this is going to take several layers. Again, this is not a technique that you want to do when performing live, because you're going to spend quite a few minutes on it. But it is a technique if you're going to do this for a special someone. That's worth doing, you know. You might want to spend the time to it, perhaps just a painting for yourself. Now I'm just adding white, and once that dries a little bit, I go over it with some more white. So see, we didn't keep just the pattern that we sprayed down. You know, we're making it, we're adding some fur with the fur technique. And I'm just gonna go up and down several times, just adding different layers. And then we're gonna go back over it with the black. Yep. See all those dark lines? Well, you're gonna go over it with the black. Kinda make it mix a little bit. Because you don't want the white fur to be completely on top of the black fur. You want them to mix, you know? You want them to even maybe even have a little bit of a gray going between the two. And yes, I'm using two different sponges when I'm creating the white. I use the sponge that has just white. And of course, you're gonna get a little bit of mixture between the two. Thus, you get a little bit of that gray, but that's okay. See, now I'm just gonna go over the black parts. Just like that. Now make it real furry. And this, you know, you don't have to stop there. I've already done several layers of white. I'm probably gonna do one more layer so that you can really see and get that effect of fur, overlapping fur. So it may take a few tries. That's okay. You know, I had a friend that really liked the wolf tutorial, and he was asking me how I did it. Well, this is the way I did it, guys. Now, I didn't spend too much time on it because, you know, at the time I believe I only had 10 minutes to do an entire painting. Now that I have a little bit more time, well, now I can spend a little more time explaining step by step how I do this. Now, check out this part. I'm not gonna finish this other side. I'm just gonna fade it in. I'm gonna use the dream technique. You guys remember that? And that's where I just fade in a color into our painting. Okay, now look at that. It looks like the tiger's laying down. There's a light source shining on his face. And then the other side, well, is still hiding behind the shadows. Now, you guys remember we added the liquid latex. He's gonna use a Q-tip. And I'm gonna rub it off. And if it doesn't want to come off, you might want to rub it a little bit more with the Q-tip. But do be mindful, try not to scratch the paint that you have underneath, so try not to use your nails or something sharp. Now, you guys remember how we added that shadow, right? Well, it worked in just fine. See, I was calculating that it would look better with the shadow on there, so that's why we did that. Now here, I'm just scratching some of that paint. Create the whiskers. Now, I'm not really keeping track how many whiskers a tiger has. I don't really even know if there's a pattern, you know? They have 16, and I really don't know. Just add as many as you think looks good. Okay, so in this case, I'm gonna add quite a few. And it's okay if you make them overlap too. It'll just give it that much more realism to your painting. Now, you guys remember our border? Now, our border, being that it's black, it fades right into our tiger. And I really don't want that. So here I added some tape on the corners. And I'm just gonna use white. Now I'm gonna bounce the spray paint off the straight edge and not directly onto the painting. See that? Okay, so that'll give us a real nice white definition. And then that white kind of fades into the black. But we're gonna use the light shadow technique. This is the same technique that I use on trees to make them look more realistic. And I'm gonna add some shadow on the other side. And believe me guys, when you hold this painting up close, you'll see it. And it'll just look that much more realistic. Okay, now see why I added the tape diagonally? So that it gives me that diagonal cut on the other end of the frame. All right, now we're gonna do this to all the sides until we complete our frame. Again, guys, remember it's very important that you spray paint or you bounce the spray paint off your straight edge. It'll give you a much better fading effect than if you were to spray it directly onto your painting. I feel you guys are ready for some more master techniques. It's taken me quite a few years, guys, to make these techniques. But, man, you guys have been there since the beginning, and I feel that you guys are pretty much ready to begin doing some more of these paintings, so keep an eye out for that. I'll definitely be posting more. The technique that we used today, where we created a stencil to kind of guide us where to create our fur lines and shadings, I hope you guys use this more often, as it will help you and save you a lot of time, believe me. Especially if you guys are gonna try and perform this live, you know, keep that in mind. And there you go, folks. Another spraycasso masterpiece in just a few minutes. All right, folks, that concludes today's show. I hope you guys enjoyed it. And if you guys have any questions or comments, feel free to drop me a line. All right, folks, until next time, keep those cans shaking.